Hello students, welcome to the online session of Sri Gokulam Public School Guruvayur. Children, we are back with the chapter 9, that is financial market. In our previous class we discussed about money market. We saw that money market is a place where trading of instruments having maturity period less than 1 year is dealt with. Now let us discuss about capital market. Capital market refers to facilities and institutional arrangement through which medium and long term funds, both debt and equity, are raised and invested. So money market is dealing with trade of those fund whose maturity period is less than 1 year, and capital market, it deals with medium and long term funds trade. Okay, so this slide was discussed earlier also. In this slide we discussed that capital market are classified into two, that is primary market and secondary market. Primary market is also known as new issue market, and stock secondary market is also known as stock exchange or stock market. Now let us see what is primary market. The primary market, which is also known as new issue market, it deals with new securities being issued or the first time. Okay, so whenever the securities are issued by a company first time, that is issued through the primary market. The essential function of a primary market is to facilitate the transfer of investable funds from savers to entrepreneurs funds seeking to establish new enterprises or to expand existing ones through the issue of securities for the first time. So what does it mean is, here we are taking the money from the savers, and the money thus collected from the savers is taken by the entrepreneurs who want to start the new enterprises. Okay, who want to establish new enterprises, or those enterprises who want to expand the existing ones. So for all these they need funds, and this fund arrangement is done from the savers. So how these funds are collected? It is collected through issue of securities for the first time. Okay, the investors in this market are banks, financial institutions, insurance companies, mutual funds, and individuals. So these are the parties who participate in the who are actually the investors, or we can say the savers. A company can raise capital through primary market in the form of equity shares, preference shares, debentures, loans, and deposits. So these are the different forms in which the funds are raised in the capital market. Funds raised may be for setting up new project, expansion, diversification, modification of existing projects, mergers, and takeovers. For all these different purposes, we have to raise the funds. And this fund requirements is satisfied through the primary market. Okay, so through issue of equity shares, preference shares, debentures, loans, and deposit, the need for fund can be satisfied. Okay, now next is the secondary market. So in capital market, as we were discussing, it can be classified into two, primary market and secondary market. Primary market deals with the new issue market, and what does the secondary market deals with? The secondary market is also known as stock market or stock exchange. You may have heard this word before, isn't it? It is a market for the purchase and sale of existing securities. So the already traded securities in primary market, if they are traded once again, okay, it is put to trade again, then we cannot move to primary market again. Okay, we have to go for a secondary market. So secondary market deals with exchange or trade of those securities which have already been traded. Okay, so we termed it as existing securities. sale and purchase of existing securities is done in the secondary market. It helps existing investors to disinvest and fresh investors to enter the market. So exist already trading investors, they can disinvest their trade, and if any new investor want to join the market, they can do it. Okay. It also provides liquidity and marketability to existing securities. So the secondary market, it provides liquidity, and also we can purchase and sell the shares here, and thus it provides the liquidity, okay, and marketability also. It also contributes to economic growth by channelizing funds towards the most productive investment through the process of disinvestment and reinvestment. Because in the secondary market, we can disinvest the shares and reinvest our shares. We can term it as a growth channelizing market. Okay, so secondary market, it contributes to the economic growth. Okay, because there is a process of disinvestment and reinvestment taking place over there. So it's the most productive investment which is channelized through secondary market. Now let us differentiate between the primary market and secondary market. So what are the securities traded over primary market? It's a new securities. Okay, there is a sale of securities by the new companies, or further new issues of securities by the existing company. So already existing company, if they are issuing any shares first time, that also have to be go through the primary market. And if the new company is issuing the shares, that also have to be moved from the primary market. And what is being traded in secondary market? It is trading of existing securities only. So the old securities which is already traded, okay, that have to be sold out through the secondary market, or trading have to be done in secondary market. Now buying and selling. Only buying of securities take place in the primary market. Securities cannot be sold here. So this is a market. Primary market is a place where only buying of securities take place. For selling this security, we have to go to secondary market. So both the buying and selling of securities can take place on the stock exchange. Okay. Now company involvement. Securities are sold by the company to the investor directly. So there is nobody in between this company and the investors. So the securities are sold by the company. So company sells this security to the investors directly. What about secondary market? Ownership of existing securities is exchanged between investors. So between the investors also trade can take place. The ownership of that securities can be exchanged between the investors. The company is not involved at all. So here the company is not involved. The trade can take place between the investors. Capital formation. The flow of funds is from savers to investors. The primary market directly promotes capital formation. So here the fund is flowing from savers. Savers are the investors who want to invest their surplus amount. And this fund moves to the who are actually in need of this fund. Okay. Now, what about secondary market? It increases incashability of securities. That is, the secondary market indirectly promotes capital formation. It's an indirect way of forming the capital. Now, price determination. Price of securities are determined and decided by the management of the company. Okay, and what about secondary market? Price are determined by the demand and supply of securities. So secondary market, price is decided by the demand and supply factors. What about location? There is no fixed geographical location. In case of primary market, there is no fixed geographical location, but for stock market, located at specified place. So for there is a specified place for a secondary market, but there is no specific geographical location for a primary market. Now let us see the methods of flotation, new issues in the primary market. So as we know, primary market is a place where new issues are done. So first time if we have to issue the securities, it is done through primary market. So it is there are different method of issuing the new securities. It is a very important question from the exam point of view, so listen very carefully. There are five different methods of floating new issues in the primary market. The first one is offer to prospectus. Second one is offer for sale. Third one is private placement. Fourth one is right issue. And fifth point is EIPOs. Let us discuss each of these points. The first method is offer through prospectus. This is the most popular method of raising fund by public companies in the primary market. So public company, they raise fund through the primary market by offering it through the prospectus. This is the most popular method. So it involves inviting subscription from the public through issue of prospectus. So the company issues prospectus and invite the subscription of the public. So if publics are interested, they can subscribe the subscribe through by looking into the filling the form of application provided in the prospectus. A prospectus makes a direct appeal to investors to raise capital through an advertisement in newspaper and magazines. So it is like an advertisement. Prospectus, issuing a prospectus by a company means they are appealing to the investors to purchase the shares issued by the company. Okay, the content of the prospectus must be according to the provision of the Companies Act and SEBI guideline. So the information provided in the prospectus should be according to the provisions of the Companies Act as and also according to the SEBI guidelines. SEBI is a regulatory body. The full form of SEBI is Securities Exchange Board of India. So they regulate all the companies. Okay, so the guideline have the SEBI provides some guideline that have to be followed before providing for an information in the prospectus. The issue may be underwritten and must be listed on at least one stock exchange. So that is very important. So a company, they have to list their name at least in one stock exchange before they go for issue of shares. Okay. So this was offered through prospectus. Here the company is directly calling the public, so there is no intermediaries involved here. So company and publics directly involved in purchase and sale of shares. The next is offer for sale. Offer for sale, this is the second method. Under this method, securities are not issued directly to the public, so we are not directly involved with public, but are offered for sale through intermediaries. So there are some intermediaries involved between the company and the public. So like issuing houses or stock brokers. So through stock brokers or through issuing houses, the companies connect with the public. Okay. So offer for sale means some intermediaries are involved. In this case, a company sells the entire lot of securities at an agreed price to the intermediaries, who in turn resell them to the investing public. So the company, what they do is they sell all the required shares or securities to the intermediaries, and these intermediaries means the brokers. This broker in turn, they will resell that purchased securities to the public who are interested to purchase the share of a company. They will sell that, the intermediaries will resell that to the public. So the only difference between prospectus and offer for sale is in offer for sale an intermediary is involved. Next, the third type method of floating of new issue is private placement. Under private placement, allotment of securities by a company to institutional investors and some selected individuals are made. So here the company, they give their shares or securities to some institutional investors. Here they are not involving public, but they are selling their securities to the institutional investors or some selected individuals. Okay, it helps to raise capital more quickly than a public issue. So inviting the public is a more lengthy process. So raising a capital through a public issue, it's time consuming, we can say, but through public placement, raising of capital is more quickly. Access to primary market can be expensive on account of various mandatory and non-mandatory expenses. So some compulsory expenses are involved there in case of primary market. Okay, so access to primary market, it is expensive. Why? Because there are some expenses involved to get in access with this market. Some companies therefore cannot afford a public issue. So public issue is a very costly process, hence some company, they cannot go for public issue. For them a better choice is private placement itself. So private placement means issuing the securities to some selected individuals or institutional investors. We are not offering the securities to the public. Okay, instead we are giving our securities to some selected individuals. So it is a very quick way of raising the capital, and it is not expensive like the public issue. Next one is the right issue. This is a privilege given to the existing shareholder to subscribe to a new issue of shares according to the terms and condition of the company. The shareholders are offered the right to pay or buy new shares in proportion to the number of shares they already hold. So children, some existing shareholders are already there with us. In our company, we already have some shareholders, and suppose we are going to issue some more shares in the primary market. So we will ask this existing shareholders whether they are interested to purchase our new shares. Okay, so making a right issue means we are giving them privilege. We are considering our existing shareholders to subscribe the new issue which we are going to issue in the primary market. Okay, so there are some terms and condition of the company for going for right issue. We have to follow that. Okay, so shareholders are offered the right to buy new shares. In which proportion they can purchase it? As per the number of shares they are already holding in that company. That is right issue. Now next is EIPOs, electronic initial public offers. Okay, it refers to issuing securities through the online system of stock exchange. So children, we are introducing our securities through the online platform of stock exchange. A company proposing to issue capital to the public has to enter into an agreement with the stock exchange. So if a company want to issue the shares through an email online platform, then they have to enter into an agreement with the stock exchange for doing that. SEBI registered stock brokers have to be appointed for the purpose of accepting application and placing order with the company. So here SEBI have registered stock brokers are available. They have to be appointed if we want to move with the proceeds of online system of issuing the securities. The company should also appoint a registrar to the issue having electronic connectivity with the stock exchange. We also have to appoint a registrar if we want to issue the online system, or if you want to issue the securities through an online system. Who is this registrar? Should have electronic connectivity with the stock exchange. If these things are fulfilled, then we can go for electronic initial public offers. That is the full form of IPOs, initial public offers. Now let us see the distinguish between money market and capital market. Who are the participants of money market? They are the Reserve Bank of India, commercial bank, non-banking finance companies, state government and large corporate houses and mutual fund. So these are the participants of money market. And capital market participants are corporate entities, stock exchange, development bank, commercial bank, financial institutions, foreign investors and ordinary retail investors from public of the company. So at least remember few of these participants. Now instruments: treasury bill, call money, commercial bill, commercial paper and certificate of deposit. We have in our yesterday's class, previous class, we already discussed this instrument. And what about capital market? Equity shares, preference shares, debentures and bonds are traded. Are the instruments which are traded in capital market. Now what is the investment outlay? Investment in money market instruments required huge sum of money, okay, as the instruments are quite expensive. So here the instrument which we are traded are quite expensive. So the investment in money market is also required a huge outlay. And what about capital market? Investment in capital market does not require a huge financial outlay as the value of units of securities are generally low. Okay, so that difference is there. Now duration and maturity period, that you know very well, that money market instrument have maximum tenure of 1 year and may even be issued for a single day. So from single day to 1 year, that is a maturity period of or duration of money market. And what about capital market? It deals with medium and long term securities having a maturity period more than 1 year. Liquidity: money market instruments enjoy higher degree of liquidity as there is a formal arrangement for this. Capital market securities are considered liquid investments because they are marketable on the stock exchange. So they are less liquid and shares may not be actively traded. It may not easily find a buyer. So that is a constraint in issuing of capital securities in capital market. Okay. Next point is safety. Money market instruments are much safer with a minimum risk of default because the parties who are involving here are having a financial, sound financial background. Like RBI and government and banks are the participants of money market. So they have a strong financial background, hence there is safety, there is minimum risk of default. And capital market instruments are riskier both with respect of returns and principal payment. Expected returns: the expected rate of return of money market instrument is less because short term, so less returns. The investment in capital market yields a higher return for investors than money markets. Okay, so these are the main difference between money market and capital market. So do study these points. Now it is time to conclude today's class. Today we saw the capital market, primary market. In capital market, primary market and secondary market are two categories of market. We saw different methods of floating of new issue of market in primary market. We distinguished between primary market and secondary market, and at last we saw the difference between money market and capital market. So children, you have to read the textbook covering these points, attend the test paper attached. Meet you in the next class with a new session. Till then, goodbye.